months ago, we reported on Thames News claims by the What an Anti-Racist Committee that members of the British movement had infiltrated 131 Independent Commando Unit in Honeypot Lane, Stanmore, in order to get weapons training. The Army's inquiry, conducted by Major David Summers, commanding officer of the unit, found no evidence to support the allegations. However, the people who made the accusations and offered to produce evidence were never interviewed. Now, Thames News has been able to prove a link between a corporal in this unit and a man who in the past has been the acknowledged leader of the British movement in South Hertfordshire. Both live on the South Oxley estate near Watford. The corporal, John Dayton of Liphook Road, stood as a National Front candidate for the Three Rivers Council in 1979.
Yeah?
I'm looking for Mr. Dayton.
Oh, he's not here. Sorry.
Where is he? Before you go away, can you tell us where he is?
I don't know at the moment.
Dayton, who's 25, has been unavailable for
There's
comment.
A notice on your door.
A notice inside the hallway of the house warns of the dangers of suspect bombs. A short distance away in Anglesey Road lives Tony Malski, who's been described in local newspapers as a British movement leader for the area.
Mr. Malski?
Is it, yeah?
Colin Baker, Thames Television.
No interest, mate.
Malski, too, is a former National Front candidate, standing in 1978 and also a year later when he stood in the same election as Dayton. In fact, Malski and Corporal Dayton lived together in Liphook Road for a year, according to the address they gave on their election documents. In 1978, Corporal Dayton was Malski's election proposer. The man who made the original claims is Mike Jackson, Secretary of the Watford Anti-Racist Committee.
The main point is that we gave some evidence in the letter. At no stage were we asked for any further evidence. At no stage were we asked where our information came from and could we give them any help in substantiating or disproving the points that we had made. So it's a very unsatisfactory situation. There's been no explanation from the MOD or from the TAs as to what type of investigation took place, and certainly I think we will want to take this matter up at a higher level.
You've made the allegations. The Army say there's nothing in them. Who's right?
At the moment, as far, nobody has been reassured at all. Perhaps the Army themselves have been reassured, but the public has not been reassured. And this issue has attracted widespread concern. It's not merely me making the allegation. It has attracted widespread concern in the community, and I think the Army owes it to the community to actually explain precisely what investigations have taken place, because we certainly have evidence that indicates there is British movement infiltration into the Territorial Army.
The next step, say the Anti-Racist Committee, should be a full inquiry by the Ministry of Defence. Meanwhile, today, after another investigation, this time in Colchester, the Army said that two full-time soldiers are not to be disciplined following their appearance in a court case with British movement members. They were said to have placed razor blades behind British movement posters. Colin Baker for Thames News, Stanmore.
Hello, I'm looking for Mr. Dayton. Hold on.
The commanding officer of this unit says that the allegations which you made are totally without foundation. What's your view of that?
Well, I am still very unhappy because I must point out it's nearly 7 weeks now since we initially wrote to the commanding officer here. Had no acknowledgement or reply to that letter. We only heard through media reports that any investigation was taking place, and I had a two-sentence letter this week indicating that their investigations had found no evidence of British movement members in this TA unit. Now, the main point is that we gave some evidence in the letter. At no stage were we asked for any further evidence, at no stage were we asked where our information came from and could we give them any help in substantiating or disproving the points that we had made. So it's a very unsatisfactory situation. There's been no explanation from the MOD or from the TAs as to what type of investigation took place, and certainly I think we will want to take this matter up at a higher level.
You've made the allegations. The Army say there's nothing in them. Who's right?
Well, I'd like to see it proved one way or the other. At the moment, as far, nobody has been reassured at all. Perhaps the Army themselves have been reassured, but the public has not been reassured. And this issue has attracted widespread concern. It's not merely me making the allegation. It has attracted widespread concern in the community. And I think the Army owes it to the community to actually explain precisely what investigations have taken place. Because we certainly have evidence that indicates there is British movement infiltration into the Territorial Army.
When you say you want to take this to a higher level, what exactly can you do now?
Well, I now have to discuss this with the rest of my committee, but certainly it will be my recommendation that we now ask the Minister to intervene in this matter.
And what evidence will you give the Minister to prove your allegations? What have you got in writing? What can you actually put on the table to show him?
Well, we can put a considerable amount of evidence on the table in respect of at least one individual. There are other individuals where the evidence is circumstantial but still warrants investigation. Now, there is no way that the Army could know of that information because simply they've never asked us for it. And so for that reason, we believe that there should be a more thorough investigation, and certainly the Army ought to make public what investigations they've actually carried out so far.
Thank you very much.
I'm looking for Mr. Dayton.
Oh, he's not here. Sorry.
Where is he? Before you go away, can you tell us where he is?
I don't know at the moment.
There's a notice on your door which says safety notice, suspected bomb or incendiary devices. What does that mean?
Nothing.
I've never seen one of those in a doorway yet.
No, I never put it there, so I don't know.
You say you've seen some?
I said I didn't put it there.
Yes. Are you Mrs. Malsky?
No.
Are you Mrs. Dayton?
No, I just live here.
Can you tell us where Mr. Dayton will be in?
I've no idea at the moment.
He does live here?
Yeah.
Are we talking about the same Mr. Dayton who's Corporal Dayton from the Territorial Army?
Yeah.
We are. Are we talking about the same Mr. Dayton who's also a member of the British movement?
He's not a member of
the,
no.
I can't hear you.
I said he's not a member of the British movement. Now would you excuse me, please?
He's not a member of the British movement.
No.
I see. Thank you very much. for the Rudd family?
Next stop.
Ah.
I don't think they're in.
Do they have a son called Mark?
Yeah, I don't think he lives there. No, I don't think he lives there.
This is where I found it.
I think the film is from Sean.
Okay.
Yes, I know that. Don't worry about it.
How long has he been married? About 4 years now, anyway. He left here 4 years.
He's left here before the baby was even born. That's part of it. If you want part of that story.
No, no, no. All I want to do is to see him talk.
Well, I don't know what side you're taking on
this. Neither do I till I see him.
Right.
Of course not. Yes, so I mean, I know, and I've read about that. But, I mean, what I would like to do is to see him, just to have a chat with him. You know where he's living.
You know Upton Road?
Yeah.
Why not try Upton Road?
Upton Road.
You say he's lived
in.
He has. That was his last address from here.
Well, Littlebro he lived there.
It's
yeah, well, I've tried that.
Right. Well, that was his last address from
here. What was the address you mentioned earlier?
I'll give you his address, I tell you, I know where he is. He's 20 Uncle Zero, so...
What's that?
And don't bloody bother me, I'll tell him too, I don't want to keep bothering me.
It's like such a shame
for
his father,
because
his father is a...
Yes, I know that, father, all about that. I'm not interested in his father.
No,
no, I'm not interested
but
in you,
must be, because you keep coming rushing here.
Well, he could have been here for all I knew.
Everybody keep coming here, see?
We get
I get phone
calls,
everything.
And
what was the name of the road?
Anglesey Road.
Anglesey Road, number 20.
Yeah.
Thanks.
That's opposite the Graves line, up the top.
No, yeah, we'll find it, don't worry. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Marsky?
Is it, yeah?
Colin Baker, Thames Television.
No interest of mine.
Cut.
if he doesn't want to come out, then that's up to him, because she's got two little babies in there, and I mean, you'll probably emotionally upset her, which is not fair, is it? They can't help his political beliefs, can they?
Is he? He's quite well known on the estate.
Oh, obviously. Yeah.
Do many people have sympathy with what he believes in?
I think that depends on your age group and what your experience is, you know?
What are your feelings about Tony Maskey?
Tony Maskey, to me, he's very nice. His political beliefs are his, and they don't interfere with my life. And I know that if I needed help in any situation, he'd be one of the first lads to offer it.
Why would you go to him?
I wouldn't necessarily go to him if he was there on the scene while anything was happening, you know what I mean? I mean, if I went arm over elbow, he'd be one of the first to pick you up. He hasn't done me any harm. He's a nice lad. And I've known him since he was about 14. He doesn't bring any interference into this street. We've never had any trouble in the street with him. So, my opinion is he doesn't harm us. He's got his own political beliefs. He's a grown man. He's entitled to him, isn't he? Mm-hmm. Same as you are and I am.
Thank you.
He doesn't conflict.
He seems to be quite well known on the estate.
Yeah, he is well known.
Does he have much support?
A lot.
Yeah. What, from young people like yourselves?
Well, not, yeah.
Like myself, yeah.
Yes.
Not just like 16-year-olds, he's got older people as well.
Yeah. I mean, obviously, I mean, we get told lots of horrible stories about things that get happening around here. But
oh, yeah.
What's your views about that?
Well, that's my opinions, like, you know, but I know Tony. I know him quite well.
Right, he is.
He's respected by lots of people.
Yeah.
Oh,
it is, isn't it?
They always are, aren't they? Yeah. Nice, you know.
And Tony doesn't interfere with you, and that's as far as we're concerned, is it? All right, in you go, boys. And shut the door. Right, shut up. I'm going down Maury for a cup of coffee.
We didn't realise you lived here.
Yes.
Yes, those are your sons, are they?
Yes.
They believe in Tony Maskey, they believe in what he stands for.
Pardon?
They believe in what he stands for.
Well, I wouldn't say that. You'll find that none of them have ever been to a political meeting in their lives.
They just told us that. Thank you.